Welcome to module 7.5, and in this we will talk about how to handle static variables. Now, what are these static variables? Right? Static variables, as you had understood in C and probably in other languages also, are those, even after they can be part of a function, they can also be global variables. After the completion of the function, what we saw with respect to the local variables, that once you finish execution of the function, the entire stack frame actually gets away, and so you don't have access to those variables after that. It's meaningless. But the static variables are those whose values are remembered through the entire lifetime of the program, right? So as far as we are concerned, the static variables are stored from the location 16 of your RAM till 255. 16 to 255 are the places where static variables are stored. After that, your stack starts from 256 and goes to a large extent, right? Now, the local variables are part of the stack and they get erased as the function goes up. But the static variables, since they have to be there, it should be between 16 to 255. So that is how we have defined the segment called the static segment, starting from 16, right. Now, what we have done is that as a part of our previous project 7, when we just say push static 0. So, we go to the 16th location for static k or whatever index. We go to the 16th location, suppose 16th location, we go to the 16th location, add 16 plus k. So, let us see, this is 10. So, now go to the 26th location. So, somewhere here 26. Whatever is content of the 26th location, that you push it into the stack. Right. So, this is how we have been handling this. Now, we have reached a stage where this will not work. The simple reason is, so last time we had main.vm, then there will be main2.vm, let us say. This has a static variable, say this has some push static 0, this has another push static 0. This has a static variable, this has another static variable. Both will be, so since both are written separately, they will all assume that they will all start with a numbering 0, right. Now, this static variable belonging to main is different from this static variable belonging to main 2, right. So, when we integrate, when we compile this, it is going to give me main.asm. When this will also give me main2.asm, right. So, this will have one static variable here and this will have another static variable. They are not part of the, they are not the same. So, this static variable is different from this static variable. So, our original technique of saying that if I have push static k, then take 16 plus k and then do. So, both will now, if I follow that technique, both will map on to the same static variable, same memory location, which is wrong. So, the simple thing that we need to do in this specifically to solve this problem is to make this. So, when I say push static k of a function name xxx.vm, right. So, you just create a label. So, you just say xxx_k@, right. So, right. So, this will basically, this will be a variable symbol. So, here you will get, for this you will get at main_0, and for this you will get at main2_0. So, whenever you see a symbol and it is a static variable, the assembler itself will start assigning from 16, 17, etcetera. So, it does. So, a main 0 will be automatically assigned by the assembler, main 2 0 will automatically be assigned by the assembler in the static segment, right. So, So you need not actually do 16 plus 0, just say at main 0 or at main 2 0. And so essentially this will be assigned a different address than this. Rather, all the variables in this main 2 will be assigned a different address from all the variables at main 0. And that will make the life much simpler. This is one part of the story. So this is something that we need to take care in the case of static. In addition, we have been using lot of labels, right? So A label, F label, we have been doing lot of labels as a part of our even assigning return address in the case of call, right? Now if we run the same code, the labels can get repeated. So wherever we have used label, like A label, last time we have used A label, we should put A some file name label. So all the labels in this particular main.vm will have the word main. All the labels in this particular VM compiling this will have main 2 inside. So this will distinguish the labels, because the label I am using here should be different from the labels I am using there. So if I execute the same program again and again, I may get into some duplication of the labels here and there, and that should be avoided. So always append the file name for that label. So labels have to be taken care by appending file names, and of course the static variables, and these two are very important aspects and modification that we need to do to your assembler translation. So let me just show you the final assembler that we have done. So this is the so this is assembler. This is the translator VM to the assembler translation, assembly translation. We have seen about stack arithmetic, etc. Now let us go back to the function call. The moment I see a function, right? So I just put the function name, because somebody wants to jump here, I have to put the function name here as a label, and then I push 0 into the stack k times. So that is the thing. And then for the return, of course I push a return address, and so when I am pushing the return address, please note that C label. And I am also putting a string here. The string is nothing but the file name. I am appending it here. I am pushing the return address, then push LC, L, push arg, push this, push that, arg spn-5. This is for the call. And for the return, this is for the call. This is for the return. Again, frame equal to LCL. All that we see here. Star frame minus I. So this is all in page 163, figure 8.5 of the book. So we just basically see all your commands being translated into the. So return is equal to star of frame minus 5. So just this is the assembly equivalent of that. Star arg equal to pop. This is the assembly equivalent of that. So like that, for every statement we have replaced by that assembly. This is what you have done. And specifically for this last part of this thing, where the statics test, in the statics test, please note that there is a sys, and this sys it calls class 1 and it also calls class 2. And this class 1 and class 2 are again two other files. They have two functions, class 1 dot set and class 1 dot get inside them. Similarly, class 2, class 2 dot set and class 2. So there is a static 0 for class 2, this file. There is a static 0 and static 1 for this file and class 2, and there is also a static 0 and static 1 for this class 1, and both these static variables are different. So when I compile all the three, then it may point to the same, and that is the error we want to reduce, right. So what we need to do is, now with all the changes that have been suggested, we need to compile this sys.vm, class1.vm and class2.vm, put them one after another, and also have the bootstrap code at the beginning. So that will form the complete ASM, which we call as static test.asm somewhere here. Yes. So this is the ASM. So if we just look at this ASM, this is the bootstrap code. It starts with the bootstrap code, right, and then it has this sys.init, sys.vm, sys.vm, and then sys.vm finishes here. Sys.vm actually basically does sys.init, and then so this is over, and so this is class 1 file, class1.vm, similarly you have class 2. So all the files we have linked together and put it on one single thing, and this we can basically run. On your VM, on your CPU emulator. Now we can load the script. And run this, and you can make it a fast one also. This runs to completion. So these are, this is this final full-fledged version of the VM emulator is necessary, which will basically convert your VM programs into the hack, wherein the static variables and other things are basically taken care of. So it has come to an end, and ultimately the same thing, right. So this is something that will solve the problem of this translation. So what we have done in this particular till project 8 and so far is that we have taken this virtual machine, a stack based virtual machine, which had a set of arithmetic operations. It had memory access operations, it has program flow, and then these calls, the function calls. And for each, what we do, we just take the whole thing, and for each statement we go and replace it with a statement by statement, we go and replace it with the corresponding assembly code, and that's the entire story. And but the care that we need to take care, we need to really matter, you know, we need to be extremely careful, is that whenever we get some of these labels and the static variables, these are some of the things that we need to handle properly, and that will make you know, the thing robust and will solve the issue for us. So take the project 8 now and complete it. I think we have given a lot of details which will enable you to work fast on this project, and use the VM emulator, use the CPU emulator for all, and all the scripts given to verify. Every time after you make the final version, there are the final version, please check all the things like project 7 and project 8. All the codes on project 7 and project 8, test with the final emulator, a final interpreter that you have written. This is called interpretation because every instruction you take and basically translate it and then put them together and run and see. So So any issues, please do log into the website and we will take enough, please put on the discussion forum and we'll ensure that your questions are answered. So kindly spend a lot of time to see that this whole thing is in good shape. All the best.